Canadians spent about the same amount of money on marijuana than they did on wine in 2015. According to estimates from Canada's Bureau of Statistics, which studied weed consumption from 1960 to 2015, found Canadians spent $4.84 billion, see $6.17 billion, in 2015. The agency also reported, in the experimental estimates of cannabis consumption in Canada, 1960 to 2015, that the level of weed consumption seems to be near the $7 billion wine market and 66% of the way to the size of the beer market at $9.2 billion. According to estimates from Canada's Bureau of Statistics, which studied weed consumption from 1960 to 2015, found Canadians spent $4.84 billion, see $6.17 billion. In 2015, only 6% of teens aged 15 to 17 were said to smoke, whereas 66% of adults over 25. As the government looks to legalize marijuana next summer, they've been looking into just how much weed consumption affects the economy. The report also found that more adults were using marijuana, as evident in its popularity over the last few years. Statistics Canada found that in the 1960s, young people were the primary users of weed. By 2015, however, only 6% of teens aged 15 to 17 were said to smoke, whereas 66% of adults over 25. Roughly 697.5 tons of weed was smoked in 2015, which equates to roughly $3.9153 billion to $4.84 billion. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has advocated for the legalization of weed that allows for individual provinces to dictate how they wish to sell it. The market value of marijuana had to be estimated in order to get the figures, as it is not legal. So the report used an approximation of $5.59 to $6.92, see $7.14 to see $8.84, per gram. Prime Minister Justin Trudeau has advocated for the legalization of weed that allows for individual provinces to dictate how they wish to sell it. Different provinces have tossed out the idea of charging $7.83, see $10, per gram. The federal government said in November that it planned to levy a 10% excise tax of $1 Canadian per gram of the retail price. 75% of the revenue will go to the provinces. If the estimates prove valid, the government could make $313,776,000, see $400 million. The agency did admit that there is currently no systematic process for measuring usage, according to Bloomberg. The figures could actually be half as much or double.